Based on the feedback I received this time, I used the fastest frameworks for both Rust and Go. For Rust, I'll use Axum, which is based on Hyper, a low-level HTTP library, and Tokyo, both developed by essentially the same team. For Go, I'll use the fastest Jnet framework that I tested in the past. I also received a pull request from the creator to improve my previous benchmark, which included a Postgres pull implementation. This time I'll run two tests. In the first one, we'll just compare the frameworks themselves by measuring throughput, latency, CPU, and memory usage. In the second, which is a way more realistic, I have a Postgres database, and each time the app receives a POST request, it saves the item to a relational database and returns it to the client. I found some weird behavior, and I hope I'll get some help to improve the Go app even further. I run all my benchmarks on AWS, and I used M7A large instance for each app, which has 2 CPUs and 8 GB of memory. I also have Graviton storage optimized EC2 instance with 3.4 TB of disk space, as well as few EKS nodes to run clients, monitoring agents, and dashboards. Alright, let's go ahead and run the first test. It took around 2.5 hours, and I compressed it to just a few minutes while editing. Once again, we'll measure throughput, which is requests per second, latency using P90 percentile measured from the client side, as well as app saturation like CPU and memory usage. As always, let me run this test for one more minute, and we'll go over each graph one by one for the full duration at the end of the test. I didn't expect such great performance from Go. Alright, first we have throughput. Axum, since its abstraction based on Hyper, was just a little bit slower in this test compared to previous one, but Go reached almost 170,000 requests per second. This is a new record for 2 CPUs. Jnet is the fastest framework I've tested over the last year. It has a very low level API, and it's kind of hard to build a web application. But anyway, next we have latency. And again, Jnet and Go were more performant than Rust. This actually surprised me. Then we have CPU usage, which was almost identical compared to the previous tests between these two languages. And finally, we have memory usage. Well, it was unexpected, but Go is a clear winner in this static test. If you can improve either of these two applications, please raise APR and I'll rerun the test. In this test, I added a Postgres database, and in addition to latency and throughput, I also measure connection pool size maintained by each application. I set both to a 500 limit. I also measure the CPU usage of the Postgres itself to ensure it doesn't become a bottleneck. Alright, let me run this test for one more minute, and I'll go over each graph one by one. Thank you. we have throughput. Once again, Go was more performant in this test, but I noticed very weird behavior, and there might be some bugs in how Go app interacts with Postgres. If anyone can investigate and fix it, that would be great. Rust reached around 39,000 requests per second. Again, it's incredibly good result compared to any other framework I've tested so far, but Go somehow achieved even more throughput in this test. It's very unusual, and full credit goes to Gnet Go framework. None of the other Go frameworks like Fiber, Gin, or others were even close. Next, we have latency, and this is actually looks unstable. Go started with very high latency, then it went down, but I saw spikes as well. In terms of latency and stability, Rust actually performs better. Next, we have CPU usage. You can see downward spikes in Go. There is something wrong with it. I increased the load at the same pace for both applications, and this behavior is unusual for web frameworks. Next, we have connection pool size. Memory usage. And finally, Postgres CPU usage. Also, there is a number of records each application inserted in the database. Go inserted about 5 million more records than Rust. So it looks like Go can be even more performant than Rust when using the fastest frameworks from both sides. Take a look at other Rust versus Go benchmarks where I used standard library as well as the Hyper framework. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.